That's two words down, system and information. That just leaves us with one more word to consider, geographic. We have this very general idea of what it means for something to be an information system, but we're not dealing with just any kind of information here. We have this modifier, geographic. Now, if you've already heard my lecture on what is geography, then you already have a pretty good idea about what geography is and what it must mean for something to be geographic. We said that the first question geography asks is where, and then talked about other questions geography asks as well. We also said geography is ultimately about the holistic and comprehensive understanding of place. Therefore, in a general sense, we might expect geographic information systems to help us understand where things are and then help us get to a holistic and comprehensive understanding of that place. All of that is true, broadly speaking, but I need something to go here in this blank before data. I can't just put in geographic because that word is in what I'm trying to define. I need another word. Could I put the word spatial in this blank? Just as I previously drew attention to the distinction between information and data, here I want to consider the distinction, if any, between the terms geographic and spatial. Are the terms spatial and geographic synonyms? Well, I think not. What is the difference between something that is spatial and something that is geographic? It is true that you sometimes hear these two words being used as if they are synonyms, but there is an important distinction that needs to be made, especially if you're working in GIS. While in an overarching sense, both spatial and geographic are concerned with locations and the relationships between objects that occur because of their location, I think geographic is a much more narrow term than spatial. Lots of people are concerned with spatial information. Take engineers, for example. When they build something like an engine, they must be concerned with the spatial relationships between all of the parts. Communicating the spatial relationships between all of them is an important component of communicating how to build the engine. It's not enough to just have all of the parts. They have to go together in a certain way. Perhaps you've heard of computer-aided design programs. They're used by engineers to help them design objects, and they certainly must take space into consideration. This is also the case with architects. When designing a house, office building, or a church, architects need to be concerned with space and spatial relationships. Even interior designers are concerned with the spatial arrangement of objects in rooms in order to make it aesthetically pleasing as well as functional. If you're online buying furniture for your apartment or dorm or living room, you can sometimes use an app right there on the website to help you arrange little pictures of the furniture you're thinking about buying to see how they will fit into the room before you buy. In all of these situations, people are concerned with spatial relationships. Computer systems designed to help with any of these tasks must take space into consideration. Even though all of the above are spatial, they are not geographic. Being geographic has something to do with the scale that is being considered. We could talk about this at great length, but generally speaking, we can say that geographic things are big. The objects on your desk have spatial relationships with one another, but they do not have geographic relationships. When you look out the window of an airplane and see lakes, mountains, rivers, and hills stretching out all the way to the horizon, these things have spatial relationships, but more specifically, they have geographic relationships. This issue of scale is important because of the specific issues that geographic information systems must take into consideration and that GIS users must be concerned with that the users of other spatial information systems may not need to consider. Generally speaking, a spatial information system becomes a geographic information system when the areas that it considers are large enough that we at least potentially have to begin to account for things like the curvature of the Earth. The Earth is not flat, and we have to take this into consideration. The fact that the Earth is spherical can have tremendous impact on analysis, and so the design of GIS software systems must take this into consideration. Have you ever had someone jokingly ask you, "What are you doing, taking into account the curvature of the Earth?" when you are paying what they think is too much attention to detail on some task? Well, in geographic information systems, though, that's not unnecessary detail. That's a foundational component. We take the curvature of the Earth into consideration in much of the analysis that we do. I realized that when exactly an area becomes large enough that we need to start taking into consideration the size and shape of the planet may be a bit vague, and it may vary a bit depending on what particular kind of analysis you're trying to do, but I still think it's a very useful component for our definition in order to distinguish geographic information systems from general spatial information systems such as those used for computer-aided design. So in this sense, all geographic things are spatial, but not everything spatial is geographic. Also, I want to point out that geographic information systems are generally concerned with information about phenomena that are taking place on or near the surface of the Earth. Again, what exactly it means for something to be near the surface of the Earth can be left a bit vague for our purposes. People use GIS to study subsurface geologic structures, and it is also very common for people to use them to store atmospheric information so they can study the weather and the climate. Similarly, we can use GIS to study oceans and oceanography. But I like to say that generally we're talking about studying phenomena that are on or near the surface of the Earth at a scale that the size and shape of the planet is potentially relevant. So if we put all of this together, we get a set of connected computer hardware and software forming a more complex whole for the input, storage, retrieval, display, processing, and or transmission of spatially referenced data about phenomena at the surface or near the surface of the Earth at a scale that the size and shape of the planet is potentially relevant. This is a much better definition than simply saying that a geographic information system is an information system for geographic information, even given the bit of vagueness about the size of the area being considered or about what exactly it means to be near the surface of the Earth. I like having a definition like this because it really does prompt you to think about all of the things that a GIS can be. Some people use a much narrower understanding of geographic information system so that only certain specialized computer applications count as GIS. I do not take this approach. I think the field is much more expansive than that. Think about some very commonly used lighter weight systems such as Google Maps or Google Earth, or even maps like Yelp or Urban Spoon that are concerned with delivering geographically referenced information. These systems qualify as geographic information systems. Certainly, some have much more functionality than others, some have more tools, some have more processing capability than others. Some may even allow different kinds of data to be input and retrieved, and some may place restrictions on what a particular user is allowed to do with the system or what data he or she is allowed to upload. For instance, Google Maps typically does not let a user upload and change the road data. They're restricted in that area, but data can certainly be input into that system if you're one of the Google Maps software engineering team. Limiting function by role like that is no problem for the understanding of GIS that I'm putting forward here. Finally, I'd like to take a brief moment to focus on the geo part of geographic information systems. Geo, of course, means Earth, and most of the instruction in a geographic information systems course focuses on the Earth, but it doesn't have to. Many of the techniques and methodologies that are learned in a class in geographic information systems can be readily applied to other planets. Maybe you develop a great interest in the techniques and methods of GIS and get really involved in the kinds of questions it will allow you to answer or problems it will allow you to solve. It's just that you think the Earth is boring and you would much rather work on something else. That's no problem. You can take all of these techniques and methods and you can apply them to a different planet. You can do the same kinds of analysis on the Moon or Mars or Venus or Jupiter, and there are geographic information systems that are specifically set up for the study of other planets, because the techniques and methods from a technical perspective are immediately transferable. Now, I don't know if we'll come up with another word other than geographic information systems for these kinds of systems that do this kind of analysis but for other planets, or if we'll just retain the word as sort of historic legacy as we move on to the study of other planets. But here, I'm not terribly concerned about that. We'll continue to be somewhat Earth-centric in this course and in others in geographic information systems, but if you want to take all of this knowledge and apply them to other planets, that's no problem at all. Okay, so much for the definition of geographic information system. I'm going to do a few software demonstrations, but before I do, I want to briefly go over a few other terms that one commonly encounters when studying geographic information systems. So that's what we'll move to next.